Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Inspirational Moments. I am Reverend Glendale Miller from the beautiful islands of the Bahamas. This program is designed to motivate, inspire, and encourage as you make a difference right where you are. I invite you in prayer. Gracious God, our Father, we are so thankful and appreciative for all your blessings, for your keeping power, for your saving grace. Bless our efforts, we pray, as we further wait upon thee. These favors and blessings we ask in your Son's name. Amen. I point you this morning to 2 Kings, the 20th chapter. Yesterday we spoke to you from verse number 1, and this morning our meditation is found in verse number 5. Turn again and tell Hezekiah, the captain of my people, thus saith the Lord, the God of David thy father, I have heard thy prayer, I have seen thy tears. Behold, I will heal thee. On the third day thou shalt go up unto the house of the Lord. I want to share with us this morning, God being my helper, when God shows up, when God shows up. This is a continuation of our study on the life of Hezekiah. Yesterday we spoke to you from verse number 1, and our emphasis this morning is on verse number 5. Another translation renders that particular verse this way: return and tell Hezekiah, the leader of my people, thus says the Lord, the God of David your father, I have heard your prayer and have seen your tears. Surely I will heal you. On the third day you shall go up to the house of the Lord. King Hezekiah was sick unto death, turning his face to the wall. He cries out to God. Hezekiah wept and pleaded for his life. God saw his tears and added more years to his life. I want to suggest this morning that he sees our tears also. Each tear we cry has meaning to our God. He keeps track of all of our tears. Not one tear goes unnoticed. God not only notices our tears, he knows why we are weeping. In 1 Samuel chapter 30, verses 3 and 4, so David and his men came to the city, and there it was burnt with fire. and their wives, their sons, and their daughters had been taken captive. Then David and the people who were with him lifted up their voices and wept until they had no more power to weep. David and his gang of 600 loyal men were on the run from King Saul. At one time, they encamped in a town called Ziklag, where they settled their families. From Ziklag, they went out to do battle, leaving their wives and children safely behind. After the end of a particular raiding, David and his army were making a 3-day journey back home when Ziklag was suddenly attacked by the Amalekites. They abducted the women and children and burned the town. No single person was left. When David and his men got home, they were heartbroken. He wept. The great warrior who brought down Goliath cried like a baby. As expected, his men also wept. David's men were brave and extraordinarily strong, yet they wept like little children. Jesus wept. The shortest verse in the Bible, John 11:35. The word weep is translated from the Greek word kreio, and it means to weep, to wail, to sob, or to shed tears. The shedding of tears is a sign of a broken heart. It is an indication that a person is hurting or in pain. The sisters of Lazarus were in a sorrowful mood. Lazarus, their brother, was dead. And it seemed Jesus had arrived too late. Hence, they wept. When Jesus finally arrived, they poured out their souls, and Jesus wept with them. He was touched by their pain and broken hearts. Jesus understood their emotional needs. There is a mystery behind tears. The Longman Dictionary defines tears as a drop of salty liquid that flows from the eye, especially because of pain or sadness. Another word for tears, crying, weeping, sobbing, wailing, and whimpering. Every single one of us has cried at some time or another. C.L. Franklin delivered a sermon on one occasion when he spoke from the book of the Revelation, where God shall wipe away all tears from our eyes. Dr. Franklin said in that sermon that where tears come from remains a mystery. And I believe, brothers and sisters, It is when you and I get in an emotional state that tears are produced. The shedding of tears is a peculiar, unique human method of expressing emotions such as sorrow, pain, despair, and disappointment. We cry tears of joy at the birth of a baby, and tears of sorrow when someone close to us dies. Doctors have said that babies need to cry at birth because it opens up their lungs and aids the normal breathing process. Tears is a normal part of life. The coming of a baby into the world is announced by crying. Our lives are marked by tears and rejoicing. Tears lubricate the eyes and help to wash away dust and other irritants. Tears express love, compassion, and understanding. Tears releases pain and brings healing. Every tear has a language. Tears speak much louder than words. Tears need no interpreter. Tears carry the message that our hearts ache and that we are hurt and broken. Crying may help lift people's spirit and make them feel better. It may mean you are frustrated, overwhelmed, or even just trying to get someone's attention. The alternative to crying is to suppress our emotional feelings. But when you suppress your emotions, you're hurting your body. Your decision to bury, ignore, internalize, pretend they didn't happen, or convince yourself that there is no need to deal with them can make you sick. Unresolved emotional issues can be released in wrong and destructive forms. The use of alcohol, drugs, a mental breakdown, abusive behavior, or even suicide. Research suggests that suppressing emotions is associated with high rates of heart disease and ulcers. The question this morning, are you restraining your emotions? Pushing those feelings aside can lead to stress and sickness. There are three types of tears. Tears help to communicate our emotions, and our body makes three types of tears. Basal tears are in your eyes all the time to lubricate, nourish, and protect your cornea. Basal tears act as a constant shield, keeping dirt and debris away. Reflex tears are formed when the eyes need to wash away harmful irritants, such as smoke and foreign bodies or onion foams. And reflex tears contain more antibodies to help fight bacteria. Then there is emotional tears, which is produced in response to joy, sadness, fear, and emotional state or position. All of us find ourselves in peculiar circumstances where we will cry sometime. But in our text, Hezekiah is informed that the God of David, his father, have heard his prayer. I want to encourage us this morning that we serve a God that shows up. He is acquainted with our grief, our pain, our suffering. In fact, in the book of Genesis, the scripture says that he has seen our affliction and have come down to deliver us. When God shows up, we can be assured of victory. And so Isaiah informs Hezekiah that the Lord has seen his tears and healing will be experienced on the third day. Oh, my family, I want you to know that no pain, no problem passes our God. He knows just what you and I are going through. He is sensitive to our plea, to our plight, to our problem. And he shows up with answers. He shows up with deliverance. He shows up with healing in his wings. Oh, you don't have to cry no more, brothers and sisters, because we serve a God who will transform our tears into triumph. He has the ability to transform our tears and give you and I a powerful testimony. You don't have to cry anymore, but if you have to cry, know this, that we serve a God that shows up in the midst of our madness, in the midst of our misfortunes, in the midst of our mistakes. He shows up. Don't you think for a second that God doesn't know what you're going through? Many of you tuning in at this hour, I see that you have been lying on your bed and the pillow is soaked with tears because you're wondering if you are forgotten. You've lost your job and money is not like how it used to be, and there's problems perhaps in the home, family issues, and with your children, with your spouse, and you may be wrestling with a physical illness. But I've come this morning to assure you, brothers and sisters, that we serve a God that will show up. He will show up on your job. He will show up in your home. He will show up in your circumstances. He will show up in the midst of a crisis. There is no challenge that you are currently facing that God will not show up. You remember the three Hebrew boys? He did not, someone said, he will not take you out of the fire, but he will come in the fire with you. God will show up at a time when you thought all hope is lost. And so I find comfort this morning from this word that Isaiah speaks not only to Hezekiah, but he speaks to you and I at this hour. Thus says the Lord, the God of David, your father, I have heard your prayer. Glory be to God. Listen to me, brothers and sisters. We serve a God who ever is inclined to our cry, to our concern. I have heard your prayer and have seen. Not only do we serve a God who can hear, but we serve a God who can see. He said, I have seen your tears, and surely I will heal you. Dry up your tears, brothers and sisters. Mary encourages us that I've cried my last tear yesterday.
I had enough heartache.
Don't you
and enough
succumb to the pain, the plight that you find yourself in. We serve a God who will show up. Glory be to God. Oh, I'm encouraged. He will show up and dry all of your tears. He said in his word, I have seen your tears. I have heard, glory be to God, your prayer. Father, we thank you this morning for this comforting and reassuring word that you not only hear, but you can see. You are touched with our grief. You are sensitive to our concerns, to our calamities, and we give you praise on this morning that even in the midst of the pain that has pushed out so much tears that flow down our faces, we are assured that healing, glory be to God, has come to our house. We take comfort this morning, mighty God, in this word. We find refuge in the assurance of this word that you're still listening to our groans. You're still listening to our whisper. You're still listening to as we lie on our beds of affliction, as we lie in confusion and dismay. You have the ability and you've given us the assurance that you're listening. Thank you, God, that you listen to your children. Oh, be assured, be assured, be assured, brothers and sisters, that God is listening. Thank you, God, that you're listening. You're not deaf. You're not clogging up your ear. You're not refusing. You're not ignoring us. But glory be to God, you're listening to every cry of your people. And we give you praise for you declared in verse 5 that I will heal thee. Healing is yours in the name of Jesus. Healing is yours. I speak it in the name of Jesus. Arthritis and tuberculosis and every physical ailment, heart disease. I speak healing over your life now in the name of Jesus. Thyroid problem, diabetes, and all of the associated and related illnesses that go with it. I speak healing. Those of you wrestling with cancer, glory be to God. You may have been diagnosed with the coronavirus. Glory. I speak healing in the mighty name of Jesus. Right this very moment. Do it for us now, God. In the name of Jesus. Healing has come to your house. Healing has come to your office. Healing has come right this very moment. Receive it now, brothers and sisters. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. It's yours. It's yours. Receive it. Believe it. Claim it. In the mighty, matchless, magnificent, marvelous name of Jesus, the Christ of God. Be blessed this morning and you be encouraged. We serve a God that shows up. Glory be to God. We serve a God. And let me tell you, brothers and sisters, when God shows up, victory is assured. When God shows up, deliverance will come. When God shows up, he brings with him the answer to all of our questions. When God shows up, he shows up with solutions. Why not this beautiful morning trust this God that shows up in the midst of a pandemic, in the midst of a prevailing problem, in the midst of pressing pain? Trust this God in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you and God keep you is our prayer. We'll talk with you again tomorrow with another inspirational message from God's word. In the meantime, may the blessings of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost be yours now. Always have yourselves a good morning. God bless.